Next question. Always leave an interview knowing A, the interviewer's contact information, B, the pay range for the job, or C, the start date for the job. Is it all of the above?
Oh, someone said all of the above. Is this another trick?
I'm passionate about that.
You know what? I'm going to go with that person. All of the above.
I'm going to say that's a little presumptuous to ask for the hours and the start date rather and the pay range. That it's a bit much. Now, if they're saying we'd like to offer you the job, the next step there is to ask these things.
So, Alyssa, our next question is: thank you letters after the interview are A, not necessary to send; B, necessary only if you think your interview went well; or C, something that should be sent within 48 hours of the interview. Audience, now, what do you think?
I wonder.
No, audience, you this. Say, would you say alert? Could that be like a responding email or something?
Yeah.
Or like,
these days, it could be an email. I mean, 15 years ago, I would have said, oh, that's so gauche. Yeah. Now, yes, it's absolutely acceptable. What isn't is a text in most cases
or
Facebook message.
Okay.
Not cool. You can even, if you really want to impress someone, get at the old fashioned pen and do one of those.
Thank you so much. Because then you'll stand out because no one ever does that.
Exactly. Wow, it's a class act.
You've got mail, literally.
Real mail. What do I do with this?
Yeah. So what is it? What's the answer,
so
guys?
So what is it?
It's C. Audience is C.
Within 48 hours.
Yeah.
Within 48 hours.
You've got to get out there. And I mean, if you thought that it didn't go well, what if it did? What if it went better than you thought? And also, you are establishing your brand, your reputation. You need to send that thank you letter out. It's a matter of professional courtesy.
Yeah.
I've known people that leave, and within 2 hours, are sending a thank you.
Yeah.
Is that too soon?
Like after a date.
It's
like,
oh,
that's a little desperate.
Yeah.
That's my first inkling. I don't think it's really, that's too soon.
Okay.
No. I think 2 hours is good.
Okay.
Okay, so listen, the next thing we want to talk about are some of your top body language do's.
Yes.
Because you're really cued into body language.
It's all I notice now with people. Yeah. I stop strangers in the street and say, you should stand up tall. No, my mother does that. So, yes, of course, walking in strong is really important. In fact, some people will watch from their offices as you walk in. Can you imagine walking in hunched over and then, hi.
Oh, my.
Nice to meet you.
If they're looking at you before you get there, I'm usually in, like, running shoes and my heels are in my purse and I'm running the shovel trying to get in the bathroom and clean up.
Well,
so we should be prepared even when we walk in.
All the more reason to be there just 10 minutes early, right? So head into the restroom, do what you got
to
do.
Getting big in the bathroom.
Come in there.
Yeah.
And what people need to know is you're always on. And by that, I don't mean be fake.
Yeah.
You have to be your authentic self. Your body language needs to convey what you believe in here and in here.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. I'm confident. I stand behind everything I say. I'm also open to what you have to say.
Okay.
So that has a lot to do with the handshake as well. No limp fish handshakes.
Oh, I hate
the worst
handshake, right, where you're cracking someone's
bones. How about shaking the hand too hard?
It can really be off-putting, although I did once give a firm handshake, and I felt that poor person's bones crack, and I thought, sorry. A little eager there. So, yeah, you want a firm handshake. Practice this with a willing or not-so-willing participant at home. It's easy. And make that eye contact.
Yeah, and that was your next one, eye contact. Yeah. So important, because you don't want to be looking around, right?
Yeah, and a lot of people have a hard time with this.
Yeah.
You want to think of how you are in a good conversation. We don't sit and stare intently at someone. It's really, really, I'm making you feel really awkward right now. It's, you look at that person, you're nodding, you're listening, you're making eye contact, you'll look away to get a thought, then
you
look back and and you let your idea land, especially if it's an important idea, and you land long enough to mentally ask, did you get that?
Mm.
You need to try that, because not only does it let them know that you're into this and you're paying attention, but it also gives you an idea. If I see, I'm talking to you, Shahir, and you're interviewing me, and I see, like, you're giving me the stink eye, I might have to ask you a probing question. Did I give you an answer you didn't expect? Talk to me. Tell me.
Yeah.
And you could do that just from this.
I can acknowledge everything you need to know.
I've got it.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Probably the most uncomfortable thing is your hands.
Yes.
Like, what do you do with
Because you never know where to put them.
The hands are something we do
especially
stuff with
standing.
These all the time. Yeah. And then when you're standing, it's especially, but even sitting, it's what do I do with these? And hands get nervous and they like to meet each other, right? I've missed you. Thank goodness. Hug me. Hold me.
Yeah.
And so this could be seen as a praying gesture or a ringing, like a word gesture.
Yeah. I'm nervous.
And I'm closing myself off to you. So you might think I'm lying. You might think I'm not trustworthy, subconsciously or consciously. So keep your body language open. Keeping your hands open is really great.
Don't shove me.
I'm
supposed to shove.
And don't shove the interviewer. That's another good.
How much space? You're...
Yeah. So you want to make sure it's strong and open and positive. No pointing gestures, right?
Oh, no, no,
I'll tell
no,
you
no,
something.
No,
yeah,
no.
I'm the person for the job.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, I'm the one you need to hire.
You got to hire me.
Yeah.
Double guns. No, we don't want to do that. We want to have the openness. And I'm offering you ideas, and I'm listening to what you have to say.
And mirroring is important.
Yeah. It is to a degree. Now, I know in the past we've talked about mirroring here on the show, and some of you, Andrea, have found it creepy, I think, a little bit. Like, you raise your cup to your lips, and I do the same thing. Well, that would be weird mirroring.
Because it's not natural, because you're just talking about be natural. Yes. And if I don't naturally want to take a sip, but you're taking a sip, I'm like, oh.
But if your interviewer is kind of sitting back and chilled, if you could do the same.
See,
you don't want to be sitting up like this.
To be comfortable.
You're going to look weird,
absolutely.
Right?
The other thing we need to know is humans are mirrors naturally.
Sure.
So if you're nodding and smiling and making sure that there's a smile on your face as you're talking, see what happens? People will naturally nod and smile as well.
That's
so use, again, if you're other focused and not in your own head too much,
you
will naturally mirror and they will naturally mirror you.
Okay, well, I'm going to mirror you right now because this is all fantastic information.
Like
thank you so much, Alyssa
Lansdowne.
Thank you. We're ready for our job interview. All right, audience, we love you, right? And to get your hair.